Hi, today I will discuss you how to write a function in MATLAB and also a plot in the MATLAB and edit the figure in the MATLAB also. So I did a model, it's called Hashin-Shrtrikman bounce model. So this is the algorithm that I have to insert in the MATLAB. So and this is the figure that I have to draw. This is Hashin-Shrtrikman. I have to draw the this is upper bound and this is lower bound, and in the x direction there is aggregate volume fraction, that means 0, 0.1, 0.2, like that. So this is a vector, and there is the Young's modulus that depends on this aggregate volume fraction. So I have to define the function that are correlated with aggregate volume fraction. So let's say when I write this equation in a MATLAB, this will create a critical equation. So I define this fraction into x, this fraction into m, and this fraction into t, this fraction into s. Let's see here, this is my handwriting. I define this portion 3c1 divided by 3k1 plus 4z1 into a small variable that calls x, and also I define this portion into m, and this complicated portion into r, and the other portion into t, and this small portion also I define y, like that, and another portion n is q, like that. So when I write k low bound, so it will be k1 plus c2 plus y plus x. I define this portion into y and this portion into x. So you can see here k1 plus c2 divided by y plus x, and the other function are same as I define here. This is the short form of this long algorithm. So this called aggregate volume fraction, that means this thing, aggregate volume fraction. So this is mainly a vector 0.1, 0.2, 0.4, 0.6, 0.8. So it will increase 0.1 up to 1. So how can I define in the function in a MATLAB? Let's see. I define this function c2, and it will start 0, and it will increase 0.1 up to one. So you can see that the c2 function is now goes to 0 0.1 0.2 0.3 up to 1. So I get the c2 value. Now when I define this c2 in the x variable, that means this variable m c2, when I define c2, so this variable m has 10 values, like that. M and like this is m1 for c2 value 0.1, this will give to m2 for c2 value 0.2, this will give m3, and like that up to 1. And similar for c1 is related with c2, like that here. C1 equals 1 minus C2. That means C1 give me like that. I want to show it. C1 equals 1 minus C2. So C1 gives me 1.9 and another vectors. So that means that this variable X also is a vector. It depends on C1. So how can I define this X variable? This is vector, this is also vector, and this is vector, this is vector, these vectors into equation. So let's see in the MATLAB. I did the function. I want to clear it. This is my script. So how can you open the script? Go here and click here. You will find a new script. So before writing the script, you have to clear the workspace as well as command window. Okay, that means there is no variable. This is the workspace, and I defined this C1, C2, E1, E2, this variable. So when you didn't clean it, this function will take the variable from the workspace defined function. For example, you write in here C1. When you run the function, then it will take the C1 value without your permission. That's why I define clear CLC. And I want to define this is the value that are recommended value. That means I find this value from here. There are some recommended value like here. This is E1, K1, E2, K2. So you don't worry about it. Just I get this value from here, and I define C2 value 0 to 1, and it will increase 0.1. C1 equals C2. I give this semicolon for I didn't want to see C1 and C2 value, and I define K1, K2, E1, E2, and G1, this variable, and I define X1. There is one something mainly mistakes when I run the program. When you define the vector, you have to give a dot in here, because without dot the function will not work. It will take only one of the vector value. That means when you give dot, then it will take like that. There is a in the C1 vector there is a 10 vectors. So when you give dot, so it will take each of the 10 value and multiply by 3. So you see here, I also when I write the C2, I also give the dot C1 dot each of the dot. Okay, so after that I correlate E lower bound with the E upper E lower bound here, K lower bound, and E upper bound with the K upper bound. And at the end, I want to see the figure. So I write in figure, and there is two figure. So let's see, right, then you can see. Okay, there is two figure. One figure is this red figure. I define this here R mean red. This give me upper bound of Young modulus, and this is the X coordinate and this is Y coordinate, and this is the color. So C2 means aggregate volume fraction. It will define in here 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, 0.4, like that. And with the proportion of C2, E upper bound will give this value like here, here, and here, like that. And for other function like float, lower bound, I define it as blue. You see here blue. So same as it is lower bound, and this is upper bound, this is lower bound. So I define in here, and I will get the get these young modulus. And how can I define it? I define it hold on function. When I give the hold on, that means it will take two function at a time, and I give hold off, that means I want to off the function. And I define the title in here. You can see upper and lower bound of Hashin-Shrtrikman model. So I write title and give the title name in here. And in the X level, I define the X coordinate name, aggregate volume fraction, and in the Y level, I define the young modulus of in GPA. You can see here young modulus. This is Y level, this is X level. So this is okay. This is the way that you can call the function and write the function, and you can run it. Okay, so after that, now I want to see how can you edit this picture. You want to define this upper bound, this lower bound. So let's take it here. This show that show plot tools and doc figure. Okay, I go there and I click in here, and I define X level in here. X level, you can also define in from here. X level, aggregate volume fraction, and Y level also you can define from here, and there is no Z level. And my the figure title is upper and lower bound of the Hashin model, and you can define this figure by clicking here. So I define this name, display name is upper bound, sorry, lower bound, lower bound, and I want to highlight this. I mean, I want to tick. So I give two. So you can see this line now thickened. And if you want to change the color, you can also change from here. Like you can change it. This is like Picasso or another. Okay. You can see it in here. And there also you can select bar. This will give you a bar. And area, this will give the area, that means only this one, and stair like that. It's a funny thing. So play with it, you can find a lot of things in here. So I need the lines, that's why I select the lines. And you also get some more properties here. Like X data, and you can also edit the data from here, 0, 0.1. You can let's say you want define this 3, 5. Okay. I define it 7, and you can define from here a lot of things. Okay, you see here when I define the data, it changes. So you can also define that Y value data as well as X data from here, and also marker size. What is marker size? Marker size means this is the diamond shape, when you change the marker size, let's see here. Okay, this is not here, marker size is here. So when you want to pentagon like that or hexagon, it will change. Yeah, from here. So I didn't change it. And there are also another option, line, arrow, double arrow, text arrow, rectangle, ellipse, etc. So you can play with it. And after that, if you want to save this picture as I do not want to save it, so I close it. There another picture. So if you want to save it, go to save as, and you can also save it in PDF format or JPEG format. If you need this picture for your research work, you can save it as JPEG format, PDF format, and another format. So let's check it, PDF format. Okay, this is the figure. Yeah, so this is the way you can define the function and get the value. Okay, see you.